and welcome to Hours After Midnight. I'm your host, Peter. I
love
you.
Today, I'm a little nervous though. I hope it goes well. I was just really bummed about the store. They didn't even have any turkeys left.
Oh, really?
Yeah. But you know what? I think it'll be great. I'm just really excited, and you know, I think it's gonna be really fun.
Oh, you want to play?
All right. Thank you guys so much for being here. And hello and welcome to Hours After Midnight. I'm your host, Peter Ski, a.k.a. Peter Miller. Okay. We have a great show prepared for you. Tonight, a lot of fun stuff going on. And let me not forget my band. Everyone, this is Daniel. How's it going, buddy?
It's great, Peter.
Oh, okay. All right. You're not enjoying the show? You didn't enjoy the limo ride? We had a beer. We got to chill.
You made me sit up in the front with the driver because you were in the back with that.
Oh, okay. All right. So look, it's Thanksgiving here. And it's one of my favorite holidays, you know?
What?
We have a lot to be thankful for, Daniel, especially here in New York. But, you know, it can be tough living here. You know why?
It's December 12th, Peter.
Okay, Daniel. you know, sometimes it can be difficult living here because it feels like a hellhole. Oh, shit, sorry. Hellscape. A hole can be filled with something to make it better. Anyway, here's some of the stuff that we should be thankful for, okay? Ready? I am thankful that the Hello carts are plentiful during Ramadan, and that the cab drivers are very understanding when you're throwing up a lamb kebab at 4 a.m. in their car. Very thankful. They did it last night for me. We're also thankful that the trains have bed bugs and not Ebola. You know why? You know, come to think of it, I would actually rather take Ebola because that way you don't have to throw out a perfectly good mattress, you know? and we're thankful that here in New York City, for our 24-hour ATMs, and that drug dealers take Venmo, PayPal, and Square. Yo, Daniel, you gotta remind me, I have to pay my drug dealer.
You owe me 40 bucks.
Okay. All right, and we're also thankful for the amazing city parks here in New York City, and that you really don't find as many dead bodies as Law and Order and my mom would make you think, you know? You know, and also, we're thankful that the NYPD does not consider groundhog manslaughter a serious crime. You know why? No, you know why? Because we'd be down a mayor. I mean, seriously.
Thanksgiving is over, Peter. It's like really over. You need to...
Okay, buddy. All right, I know. Oh, you know what? We're thankful for the rats that are in the subway. Don't realize that there's better food on the train than on the tracks. Have you ever seen people eat on the train? You're not home. Eat at home. This is good. We're thankful that the humans of New York didn't choose a place like Omaha, Nebraska. Although, really, what would humans of Omaha even be? Just cows and grass. Cows and grass.
I'm pretty sure people live in Omaha, too, Peter. I think so.
Okay. All right. I'm sure they do, too, Daniel. We're thankful that we have two wonderful climates outside of the subway station and one inside. Get me on this one. One smells like piss, warm, and the other one smells like cold piss. Okay. No, listen to this. New Yorkers don't just celebrate Thanksgiving once a year. We celebrate it all year round. You know why? Do you know why? Because we're so grateful that we make it home safe without being mugged, run over, peed on, or forced to talk to somebody on the subway car.
You know what? I'm just thankful nobody's going to see me on the show.
No. Daniel's got a point. Daniel definitely has a point. You know, I was worried that no one was going to be able to watch this show because of all the great sports that are on this time of year, right? I mean, a lot of good games, a lot of good basketball games. But I realized that the people watching sports probably don't fit into our demographic. My mom, the NSA, and people who died watching public access. No, of course, the holidays are a time when we don't have to work. We travel. We have horrible debates with people we don't even like and are forced to spend time with. In other words, it's a time when we all pretend to be Congress. Like I said, I am so happy to be hosting Hours After Midnight. We have an amazing show. Thank you guys so much for watching, and please enjoy. Thank you, Daniel. Sorry, Daniel.
Sure.
Lionel, will you hurry your slow ass out here and get the kids? Are the kids ready yet? Come on.
We don't have any kids.
Oh, yeah. Great. Then what are you doing back there?
I'll be right out!
I swear to God, Lionel, if you are playing with that fucking blanket again, I'm gonna divorce the shit out of you!
It's called a security blanket, and it's totally normal!
I'm pretty sure we had a kid at some point. I think I was pregnant at the wedding. Damn it. Hi, Charles.
Holla?
Holla? Really? Who are you? Missy Elliott? You are a grown-ass man, Charles Brown.
Happy Thanksgiving to you, too, sis.
Please don't start with that shit. Who invited you here, Charles?
I invited him. Come on, your brother's like my best friend, and we haven't seen him in years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because he's a loser.
Hey.
You guys deserve each other. Did you get a job yet, Charles?
Hey. I'm gonna just ignore all the mean questioning and, how are the kids?
We don't have any kids.
No.
Okay, all right. So I know it's Thanksgiving and all, mm-hmm. and I'm sure you guys don't want to be thinking about making some money, but I just met this girl at the bar, and she turned me on to this business venture?
No more pyramid schemes, Charles.
It's not a business. It's not a pyramid scheme, okay, sis?
Mm-hmm.
It's not. Okay. It's energy drinks.
Yeah.
It's energy drinks, okay?
Great.
All right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. So, look, all I have to do is sell 100 of these to everybody I know,
mm-hmm.
and then they go out and sell 100 of them to the other people.
Yeah.
And,
yeah, I'm pretty sure that's a pyramid scheme, dude.
Oh. I have 5 cases in the car.
What were you even doing in a bar on Thanksgiving morning?
I slept there. Oh. I'm not doing good right now. Look at me.
Jesus, sorry.
All right, well, shit. How are the kids?
We don't have any kids.
Oh, didn't the doorbell ring?
Oh.
Yeah. Loopy!
Okay.
He says it's good to see you after so long.
Oh, well, if I'd known we were going to have a celebrity in town, I would have put out the fine china.
Wait a minute, you're my dog? Loopy?
Wait, we have other china?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Wait, that's my dog Loopy?
Yeah, dude, it's...
Don't you remember, Charles, you guys were always playing together when you were kids?
He was my dog!
Oh my God, we really don't need to go into that.
Oh my God.
Mr. Luffy refuses to discuss his horrible childhood with Charles Brown.
Well, I bet. I mean, probably because he's a dog.
Ignoring you.
Okay. Let's not talk about who treated who like a dog when we were kids. I mean, come on. Kids are dumb. That's why we got rid of our... I mean, that's why we've never had any kids.
Yeah. Oh, my God. What I cannot believe he's...
Yep, okay. Well, you know what, Loopy? How are you? I hear you're a big shot Broadway producer now.
He's a director. That's a difference! I
guess there's a difference.
Knock, knock. Hello, Charles.
Oh, man! Patricia Panties?
My, how you look, oh, so... same. And please call me by my given name. It's Patricia.
Oh, my God. Patricia Panties? I've been whacking off to Patricia Panties for years, and I didn't even know it was her! Damn!
Beat it.
Look at you.
Hi, everyone. Patricia, look, we're just in time for dinner.
Oh, perfect. I can't stand any more small talk with these assholes.
Hey! Oh,
except you, Allie. Thank you.
Loopy concurs.
Loopy!
Salutations, and I'm Derek!
Hi, Lionel. How's your blanket?
Totally normal.
How's your shitty football career going, Charles?
It was going okay until my bitch-ass wife, like... maybe join some football game or soccer or like kickball. Oh, and I broke my coccyx. That's not funny. That's not funny.
How is Lucinda?
I don't know. Married to some piano guy? I have no idea.
Schrodinger?
Mm. Yeah, maybe.
You both know he changed it to Justin Timberlake after he joined that boy band. Excuse me.
Justin Timberlake. What a stupid name.
No more stupid than Lionel. Sounds like a legal ripoff of a better, more famous name.
Okay.
Mr. Loopy's bored and hungry.
Yeah, yeah, and I'm sure a dog.
Loopy's right.
Silence.
We should eat.
Yeah.
Please. Oh,
let's.
Please, let's all sit down.
So, what's everyone thankful for?
Oh. I am thankful that my last, two suicide attempts, were unsuccessful, but now that, Patricia Paintings is back, I'm much more happier.
Have you tried jumping off a building?
Yeah, Charles, seems like you're even a failure at suicide.
Mommy! Bobby!
Damn it! I thought what? I left you in the swamp!
Ladies and gentlemen, Shilpa Ananth.
Yeah. This holiday season, treat your family to a Broadway classic like you've never seen it before.
What time is it?
Showtime! 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 Les Mis on the subway!
This year, the cast of Les Mis is bringing Broadway to you in their most ambitious performance to date.
On my own, pretend.
The wonder.
I've got a castle on a cloud.
The intrigue.
Master of the house, dorming of the charm, ready with a handshake and an open palm.
The emotion.
He took my childhood in his stride.
All on your commute to work.
There's some faces and windows. Shadows on the floor, empty chairs and empty tables, where my friends will meet no more.
Shut the fuck up! Shut up! Shut the fuck up! Shut up! Shut up! Shut up!
Act now! Get tickets at your nearest MTA box office.
So I have Joyce, Sherri here and Robby Johnson from the show Sherman. All right, so let's check out a clip from Sherman.
Maybe you should talk to Anna. Off the record, of course. I'm sure she's had some patients with a similar crisis. Plus, it'll give you a chance to get to know her a little bit better.
I don't need to get to know your shrink girlfriend a little bit better.
I asked her to marry me.
Why'd you do that? You get her into trouble?
Get her into trouble? What is this, the 50s? I love Anna. And yeah, she's pregnant. Sherman, take it easy. Okay, you're not exactly the poster child for stability right now. And excess amounts of sugar have been known to worsen anxiety symptoms and impair the body's ability to cope with stress.
That was an amazing clip. How did you come up, Joyce? How did you come up with Sherman?
It actually started as an adaptation for the graduate film program. I'm in the MFA program at New York University.
Oh.
And we needed to do an adaptation of an original story, and they let us pick whatever story that was, and I thought I was going to do Sleeping Beauty.
Ah.
So the first episode is kind of an adaptation of Sleeping
Beauty.
But that's generally where it came from.
Okay, and where?
I've never heard.
You didn't know that?
Oh. I had no idea.
So this is the first time he's hearing this.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, maybe we should go.
I thought it was like an adaptation of Animal House.
No. I originally thought.
Well, she's working on that. That's the next one, right? Well, no, where did the decision come to create the series?
So the first episode, which is online, is the actual short film that was created as a part of the program.
Okay.
And the series didn't come until after the short film. I originally created the first episode that you see.
Yeah.
As just like a standard short film, beginning, middle, end, nothing else beyond that. But it was so well received at the marathon at the end of the year that, you know, I had somebody actually approach me about doing a TV pilot for the character and for the show. And my mind wasn't in that frame of thinking, but I knew I didn't want to sit on it. You know, everybody seemed to like it.
Right,
so I thought, you know, why not do a web series? So I asked Robby, and obviously he was down for it.
So how many more episodes are we going to? Did you already finish the first season?
No, we're still on the first season. So right now we have, there's one episode that's in post right now. It's sort of a narrative mix of, it's a narrative and a music video.
Oh, okay.
So there's a little delay in that because I'm trying to secure my music for that.
Okay, okay. It's very hard.
Yeah. So, but then also I plan to shoot one more episode and complete the first season.
Is, I'm reading off this, but Robby, is it hard playing Sherman? Is there any difficulty? Do you relate to the character?
If you asked me if it was hard playing Sleeping Beauty, and I'm still wrapping my mind
around that. Like, why didn't you not ask him to do that?
I had no idea.
Okay.
you know, I mean, it's, in some ways, it's, there's a little bit of Sherman in all of us.
Yeah.
In that, Sherman's a guy without a filter.
Okay.
And so.
That's why I had this show.
Yeah, it's kind of like a guilty pleasure to indulge in that filterless world.
I live my life like that.
Yeah.
Have you met my parents? No, but this is not about me. No, there's talk about the show, Sherman going into a feature film.
Not right now. Like, I'm trying to finish the first season.
Oh, okay, okay.
But then once that's done, we'll see if I
progresses to go
into a second season. Okay. Possibly. I would love to do that.
Okay.
But I have various projects all in different stages of development. I'm trying to carefully pursue other avenues.
Okay,
so,
okay.
You know, we'll see where it goes.
All right, all right. Now, what would it be if you had not taken the steps to love, like, New York or work with the, imagine yourself in New York?
I don't imagine that I would not have moved here. Mm. I'm not the type of person who doesn't do what makes me happy.
Right, okay,
so,
right.
So I'm just like, I moved here even before I got accepted to NYU because I just wanted to be where people were making films, and they're not doing that in Virginia where I'm from.
Okay.
So, you know, it's just, it never occurred to me not to be here. And if I wasn't, if we had to go down that road, which I don't really like to think about,
I would
probably still be in Virginia, like, you know, producing some more plays for my church or something like
that.
Not
to diss on Virginia, but I'm sure
this. Love you, VA.
But New York is where it's at. Like, you come here to make films, to be seen, to be heard, and Sherman is an amazing show. Last question, Robby. When you're not playing a suicidal accountant, you know, what are you up to? What do you do on the side?
I'm an actor.
Okay.
In New York.
Okay.
And sometimes out of New York doing plays regionally.
Okay.
And when I'm not doing that, I'm waiting tables and all kinds of things that actors do.
So great. Awesome. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, you have to check out this show. It's called Sherman. All right. And Joyce, where can we find the web series on?
Right now we're streaming on Vimeo. So you can go to Vimeo.com and type in Sherman the
Excellent.
Web series and find it there.
Joyce, Robby, thank you guys so much for being here.
Thanks for having us.
Sherman is the show, and you guys have got to check this out. Thank you guys for both being here. It was a pleasure.
Thank you.
All right, guys, thank you so much for being here. Your EP drops on February 13th, right?
Yes.
And at the Blue Note, right?
Yes.
Thank you guys so much for being here. All right. Everybody, Shilpa, Ananath, check them out, and they're going to play us out.
If you walk away, what could I say? Can you let me go? Can you really de unnai naan vidamaten enne vittu pogade onnum solla de enne vittu pogade